It's March 21, 2024. I'm here at the World Health Organization during the negotiations on a pandemic agreement. I'm here with Pedro. Pedro, can you tell people who you are, who you represent, why you came to Geneva for this meeting, how you think things are going in the negotiation, and what advice you have for the negotiators?
Okay, so my name is Pedro Villardi. I'm part of the Health Equity Team of Public Services International. It's a global union federation representing more than 150 countries and representing 30 million workers around the world that work in public health services. So this week I'm here because it's very important that the future instrument on pandemic preparedness, prevention and response will include strong clauses that will protect workers, healthcare workers, so that we can be better prepared and face the future pandemics with more protection, with better working conditions, and with better working conditions, so that at the same time those workers can save lives and be safe as well, because safe workers save lives. As far as how the negotiations are going, yesterday the INB discussed Article 7, which is exactly the article on health and care workforce. And we've seen some delegations with good propositions, proposing strong languages, but we have also seen delegations, especially from the Global North, trying to weaken those languages and trying to remove every commitment possible to the parties, so that those workers would be protected, including some language that is already present in several international instruments and present in ILO's conventions, something that would be totally consensual, but that was not the case yesterday. So the advice that I would give to the negotiators would be to protect the workers, promote decent work, protect the workers' families, and also care about the other provisions that have to do with technological transfer, that have to do with strengthening the Global South production capacity. We need to have public-led local productions initiatives so that we can decentralize the production of health technologies for the next health emergencies. And we also need to have an equitable pathogens and access and benefit sharing system that does not impose these obligations to southern countries, and also to share that pathogens and genetic database, but also have obligations in terms of access to the benefits of the sharings that will happen.
Is there anything, what has surprised you in your in following these negotiations?
What surprises me is that the things that were proposed to be removed yesterday are, for instance, decent work, which is a concept by the ILO that has many decades in place. That is a consensual concept that is all over the international agreements and instruments, and it should be already incorporated in this instrument. It was not. It was due to a lot of pressures by trade unions in Inter-Americas, in Africa, and in Asia Pacific, telling their governments to push that concept, but unfortunately, countries from the Global North, especially the United States, have proposed to remove language on decent work, and removing the commitments and obligations by each party to protect and to promote the decent work, because decent work comprises fair wages, comprises non-exhausting hours of work, comprises also social dialogue, which is a key mechanism of collective bargaining and the right to strike. So it's a concept that comprises several pillars that are key for health workers to organize and to defend their rights even in times of pandemic. Because it's not because there is a health emergency that health and care workers cannot have their rights respected.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.